Here at the National Gallery in Washington, D.C., a portrait from the early 1800s depicts life in the U.S. House of Representatives. As you can see, not one woman is pictured in this painting. But if it was painted today, it would look a little bit different. Five women, just five of the 20 that are a part of the current U.S. Senate. But these women are proving that it's quality, not quantity.
It's a good group of women, and I think we all take our jobs seriously.
They're mothers, grandmothers, sisters, and senators, balancing their day-to-day home lives while balancing a budget and entire states on their shoulders.
We want to be efficient with our time, and we want to work things out. And I think that's what you see reflected in the Congress.
They say they focus on the issues and not an ego.
It shows in the way they conduct themselves and the way we all conduct ourselves with one another. We're problem solvers.
And the proof is in the numbers.
Female legislators have this traditional lunch where they get together and, kind of started by Barbara Mikulski, have no staff, no press, and no leaks, sit down and talk about kind of what they're doing legislatively. And we wondered whether the fact that, at least in the Senate, female legislators seem to have this special bond and seem to try and work together more, whether we could find out whether this was the case.
Forum, an online legislative strategy platform, took their curiosity to the database. And what they found?
Female legislators are more effective. They get more bills, at least in the Senate. They introduce more bills, they get more bills out of committee, and they get more bills enacted.
Their results showed that women in both the House and the Senate are more likely to work together and get more done. According to the firm, the average female senator introduced 96.31 bills over the last 7 years, while their average male senator only introduced 70.72 bills.
I think against a lot of tough odds, a lot of times when you look behind the successes in the Senate, there's going to be women leadership.
Senator Heitkamp commended Senator Stabenow for getting the farm bill through. And they say Senator Collins and others were credited for ending the government shutdown back in 2011.
I think many times women are known as the ones here in the Senate who break through the gridlock, because we do want to accomplish things and we're willing to sit down, negotiate, compromise a little bit. Maybe not compromise our principles, but compromise a little bit just to get the right result.
So what if more women were in Congress?
We will be better governed when our legislative bodies look like America.
The more women, I think we will see, the more we get things done.
I'd love to see the day when we're, you know, 50 women, 50 men. That would be great.
I always tell my kids, you know, if somebody's mad at you, go stand next to them. They kind of laugh at me. I said, because it's really hard to maintain a grudge when somebody's standing right next to you. Eventually, all of that ice and all of that animosity melts. And that's the theory behind the bipartisan women dinners. We all get together. You know, we could be mad at each other the day before over whatever issue, but if you're sitting next to someone breaking bread, it's harder to stay mad.
It's good to be able to do that. It's good to let your hair down. It's good to know you're in an environment where you can share maybe some challenges that you're facing with people who are going through the same things.
Just sharing what it's like to finally have a women's restroom in the Senate that's actually big enough for 20 women senators. You know, that was a pretty big deal. It took a lot of years to get that to happen.
And about those dinners, they didn't reveal any of the juicy details, but they did say they keep up with them every month without fail. Reporting in Washington, I'm Kelly Meyer, Moms Every Day.